Tomorrow marks the 20th anniversary of the Loma Prieta earthquake. It had a big impact in much of Northern California, and remnants of the damage still linger here on the Central Coast even today. Action News reporter Ravi Kapoor has the story live from Salinas.
Well, Dan, the 7.1 quake lasted just 15 seconds, but in Santa Cruz, the effects of the quake remain present.
Oh my gosh.
While much of the world was transfixed on the devastation caused by the Loma Prieta earthquake to San Francisco and Oakland, Santa Cruz sustained damage that completely transformed its downtown.
Everyone remembers where they were at 5:04 on October 17th.
Santa Cruz Mayor Cynthia Matthews was in the heart of it all on Pacific Avenue.
I was in a windowless room. The whole room started falling apart, and after the earthquake stopped, I saw light. Not a good thing.
It completely changed our lives in a second.
Casey Coonerty Prati was just 13 years old.
At the last minute, he grabbed the rocking horse and ran out with it.
Now she's running the family business, Bookstop Santa Cruz, a downtown business that was able to survive the collapse of their building because of the efforts of the community.
People rallied around to help us to get us through the time, and we still think about it. We're still emotional about it, and we still really appreciate everyone for what they've done for us.
By and large, other than the big hole on Pacific where the bookstore once stood, Santa Cruz's reconstruction is complete. But 20 years later, the quake lives on, defining a region and its people forever.
I think the fact that everyone came together is something that defines Santa Cruz and continues to this day. And I think it really made us really think, what does it mean to be a Santa Cruzan? And I'm proud of what we've come up with.
Watsonville and Old Town Salinas were also gravely affected by the earthquake, but officials say to this day that the loss of life could have been a lot worse. Keep in mind that on October 17th, the Giants and A's were playing baseball on TV, and that certainly limited a lot of the folks that were scheduled to be in rush hour traffic. Dan?
All right. Thanks very much.